Hi everyone, my name is Federico Tartarini, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can add a new Python interpreter to PyCharm. So here on my computer, I have the latest version of PyCharm installed. I'm using Windows, but this guide will also work if you are using Mac. It's the same process. So if we go here at the top, we can see that in the configuration, at the moment on my computer, we have only two Python interpreters installed on my computer. So we have Python 3.7 and Python 3.8. I want, however, to create a new project with the latest version of Python, which at the moment of this recording is Python 3.9.2. So let's first install Python on my computer. So we just have to go and navigate to python.org. Here in the download section, is going to be probably looking a little bit different when you open this page again in a few months, but just look for the download section and then click on Python 3.9.2 in my case, and then let's scroll down and let's look at the recommended version for my specific computer. So I'm using Windows 64-bit, so I want to install the Windows installer 64-bit. So I click there, I save the file on my computer, and the file will be automatically downloaded on my computer. So once it's downloaded, let's double click on this file, which is going to be open, and we are going to click here in Customize Installation and choose Location and Features. Okay? So we click on this one. We want to install Documentation, Pip. We keep all these things as default, that's fine. And we want to also select the location. We can install Python wherever we want, so that doesn't change. However, it is important that you copy this string, so this install location, if later on PyCharm is not going to be able to pick it up. So I know already that it's going to be able to pick it up, but it's important to know this location here, so you can reference it every time that you need to look for your Python interpreter, okay? Because each Python version is installed in a different location. So let's just keep in mind that this is our exact location. And if you want, you can also copy it here in Notepad. So let's just go ahead here. So we can just copy here in Notepad, just for reference, okay? So then we can click on Install. And this is going to install Python 3.2.9 on our computer. It's going to take a minute, so I'm going to fast forward this section here. Great, the setup was successful, so we can close this tab here, we can close the browser, and we can open full screen PyCharm. So to create a new project and to set up a new Python interpreter, we have two options. So either here, File, New Project, here, and then we create a new project. However, if you are not in this project view, you might be prompted with this view, the welcome screen. So let me close this project and I will show you the welcome screen. So this is the welcome screen. So we're going to create a new project, same thing, same tab. We decide where we want to put the project. In my case, I want to put it into the downloads folder. And then I'm going to select a Python interpreter. I don't want Python 3.8, but I want to select a different interpreter. But as you can see, the interpreter is not coming up by default because we just installed it. So we have Python 3.7 and Python 3.8. How can we add Python 3.9? We just have to click here on this button, the three dots, and then we look for system interpreters. We use this drop-down menu here, and we look for the interpreter. Now comes Andy, that string that we just saved before, because if it doesn't pick it up automatically, we can just copy and paste it here, and then we select here Python 3.9, and then we have Python X, okay? So we can just click here, and now we have our interpreter. Then we click OK again, and now we have Python 3.9. So we have Python 3.8, Python 3.7, and Python 3.9. Fantastic. So now that we have Python 3.9, select as the interpreter, let's click on Create, and this is going to create our project. So this is the default project. Let me finally show you how you can add packages, because right now we have installed the Python interpreter, so Python 3.9, but we don't have any packages installed inside Python. How can we do that? That's super simple. So we just have to press Ctrl-Alt-S to open the settings menu. Alternatively, you can go in File, Settings. So you go here, at the top you type Interpreter, Python Interpreter, and you can see all the packages that have been installed already inside Python. Okay, so at the moment I have pip, setup tools, and numpy. If you see a narrow up symbol here, it means that this is not the latest version and you can update that version. How can you do that in future? You just click on this line on multiple lines and you click this arrow up here button, which is upgrade. In my case, I have all the packages already installed. If you want to add another package, super simple, we just have to click here on plus install, and then we look for pandas, for instance, and then we select the package that we want, or for instance, you could look for a Flask if you're building a web application, and then we click here, install package. At the bottom here, you will see a message saying install package, Flask, and the Flask was installed successfully. You can close this tab here, and now you can see that you've installed Flask and all its dependencies here on your computer. So you can hit OK, and then now, for instance, if you want, you can import NumPy as np, and you can import, for instance, import Flask, okay? So if you want. Of course, if we try to import pandas as pd, we're going to get an error message. So another way that we can install a package is by pressing Alt-Enter, where we get the error. So if you press Alt-Enter, PyCharm automatically is going to ask us to install package pandas. So let's press Enter. PyCharm is installing pandas for us automatically. So it's going to take a little bit of time because pandas has a lot of dependencies and is slightly a bigger package than NumPy or Flask. But in a few seconds, pandas will be installed on our computer and we can go ahead with our code and keep coding. I will show you also in the settings that panda has been installed. So if I click again on press Ctrl-Alt-S and I go back here to the interpreter, now you can see that also pandas has been installed on our computer. I really hope you find this video interesting and useful. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comment section below. And see you next time. Thank you very much for listening.